Now I just want to show a close-up of the dogs. So here's one of the puppies, and I'm naming this one Spot. And here's the back. And what's nice about Spot is the paws move up and down, and so do the legs. And then you could take the hat off. And this is what Spot looks like without his hat. And here's a close-up of the female puppy. And here you can see the hat. And from behind. And she also moves her paws and her feet. And then here is the big female dog. And you can see how pretty her eyes are. And her hat. And this is what she looks like from behind. And I made her design a little bit different, so she doesn't, her legs don't move. She just sits up straight. And that's the same way that I made. And his name is Sparkles. He's got his little fireman hat. So he's the same way. He just sits also. Just turn him around. And then those are the dogs. So for this project, you're going to need your F or 4 millimeter crochet hook, as well as a tapestry needle and a pair of scissors. The yarn that I used was by Effervesse, and it's Yarn Bee. And it actually is normally $5.99, but I got it on special. That's why I wanted to try it. And it's really fun to use for amigurumi because it has a fuzzy appearance to it. And the white color that I used is called Stardust. And this is how much I had left over after just one puppy. So if you make one puppy, let me just get the puppy. So if you made one puppy, this is how much of that yarn you would have left over. And I'm not sure if it's enough to make another one or not. Now for the larger dog, you're going to need two of these, of the Effervesse yarns. And I had to use a little bit more than two, so I used a little bit of the puppies, what was left over of the puppy. So with one puppy, this is how much you have left over. And then after making one of the big ones and one puppy, you have, this is what's left over of the third one that you have. Here's a little bit more information on the yarn. And this yarn is really soft and fun to work with amigurumi. Now, if you like this color, I call it turquoise, but it's actually, the name of it is aqua. And it's from Yarn Bee. And it's the Soft Secret aqua color. And this is what I had left over after making the dogs. So I have plenty left over for more
And I also
projects.
used Yarn Bee's Soft Secret White color, and it's a really shiny white color that I used on the fireman hat and also the eye for Sparkles, the male dog, the large one. And I also used Effervesse Veil Pink by Yarn Bee, and it's a similar yarn to the Stardust. It's a fuzzy, soft yarn. And this is how much you have left over. I used it for the inner ears of some of the dogs and for the
I
flower.
also used Yarn Bee Soft Secret Black yarn for the spots on the dogs, as well as for the big dogs for their eyes. And for the eyes for the female big dog, I used Bernat's glittery greenish colored yarn. I forget the exact name of it, but this is a baby soft yarn by Bernat.
And then for the cherry red fireman's hat and collar, I used the Red Heart Super Saver Jumbo. And of course, I had a lot more than this. This is leftover yarn that I used to make the hats and the collars with. The ribbon that I used for the female hats is by Celebrate at Tempo. And this is a 3/8 inch yarn. And it's a real pretty glittery white yarn. The real pretty eyes that I used for the puppies were Suncatcher Craft Eyes. And they're 20 millimeters in size. And here is a close-up of the eye. It's really pretty. And it's got a safety latch for the back part of it. And then I'm going to show you the females. And this one is close-up of her eyes, real pretty green. And I just used some regular pillow stuffing, a real inexpensive pillow that I used for the stuffing. To make the snout, you're just going to take your yarn and fold it over on itself. We're going to do a slip knot. Once you form a loop, just put your crochet hook through the loop and hold it at the base with the middle, your middle finger and thumb. Then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. And now you're going to make a chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have a chain of 10. Go ahead and hold that last stitch with your middle finger and thumb. And you're going to move up to the next row. So you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for another chain. And then you're going to go into the second chain from the hook, which is the stitch that you're holding. So you go into that stitch with your crochet hook. You're going to bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. Now you're going to do a single crochet into every stitch, all the way back across, and then come back. Now I have one stitch left. You're going to do three single crochet into that last stitch. And at the same time, you're going to be burying that loose yarn end. So you just go behind the loose yarn end. So three single crochet into that last stitch. And now you're going to be turned to the opposite side of your work. So you just finished working along this side. Now you're going to work on the other side. So you can keep working behind that loose yarn end to bury it as we go. So you go into the first stitch on the other side, go behind the loose yarn end, bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet. And then you're going to do a single crochet into every stitch, back across. And then in the last stitch on this side, you're going to do three single crochet into the last stitch on this side, and then come back. This is how your work should be looking, and I just did three single crochet in my last stitch. Now you can get a yarn marker and place it right where you left off. It'll help you keep track of the rounds. And you're going to do a single crochet into that first stitch. And now you're going to do a single crochet all the way back across. And then on the end here, on the other end, you can see that there are three stitches, one here, one on the very end, and then one on the other side. So you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch all the way down. And then in the stitch on the end, you're going to do two single crochet in that stitch. So go ahead and do a single crochet all the way down and then come back. So this is how my work looks right now. I just finished doing a single crochet all the way down. Now I'm on the end. So I'm going to do two single crochet into that end stitch. And then I'm going to start working on the opposite side back to the yarn marker. So I'm going to do one single crochet into every stitch until you reach that stitch right before the yarn marker, because that's the other side's end stitch. You're going to do two single crochet into that stitch and then come back. Okay, so go ahead and move your yarn marker up. And this is how my work looks so far. Now I'm going to do a single crochet all the way back to the other side. So now on the other side, you can see that you have two stitches on the very end. So you have one, two stitches on the very end. So you're going to do a single crochet into every stitch right before the two stitches on the end and then come back. So this is how my work looks right now. And I just reached the end. So I'm going to do two single crochet into the next stitch. And then two single crochet into the second stitch. And now I'm working on the opposite side and going back to the yarn marker. So go ahead and do one single crochet in every stitch, but in the last two stitches, right before the yarn marker, you're going to do two single crochet into each of those two stitches and then come back. You should be back to the yarn marker and your work should be looking like this. Now you're going to take your yarn marker, move it up, and you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch for three rounds. So go ahead, finish doing one single crochet into every stitch for three rounds and then come back. You should have finished three rows, one, two, three, or three rounds. Now you're going to do a slip stitch. Go ahead and take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch over, yarn over, and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. Then go ahead and finish off, just yarn over, and pull enough yarn through to sew the snout onto the dog. And on the snout, you have the fuzzy side, which I'm using as my right side, and then the other smooth side is the wrong side. Now we're going to make the nose. And for my nose, I actually use the Yarn Bee Soft Secret black yarn. And this is what it looks like. But on video, I'm going to show you how to make it with the blue yarn so it shows up a little better. So the first thing we're going to do is the magic circle. Just take your blue yarn, drape it across your four middle fingers, stabilize it with your thumb, and just wrap it around twice around the middle fingers, and then hold it with your pinky and your thumb. Then you take your crochet hook and go under those two loops, bring up a loop, and then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for your slip knot. And now we're going to do six single crochet into the magic circle. I'm going to go slow so you can see how I hold my fingers. And the last one. Then go ahead and take your forefinger and your thumb and just hold it at the base of the six single crochet. And then you have the two loops on the opposite side. You're going to pull on one and see if it closes. If it doesn't close, then you let go and pull on the other one, but this one's closing. Just close it loosely. Then take your loose yarn in and pull on that. We can always close it more later. Now you're going to do two single crochet into every stitch around for a total of 12. So go ahead and go into that first stitch. You're going to bring up a loop. You have two loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. And then go back in the same stitch, bring up a loop, yarn over, and then go through both for a single crochet. So two single crochet into every stitch all the way around for a total of 12, and then come back. Now we can close the center of the magic circle. Just turn your work over and pull on that loose yarn end snugly And then that closes up the center nicely. Now you're just going to get a scrap piece of yarn and place it right where you left off and use that as your yarn marker. And we're going to do an increase round. So you're going to go into the next stitch over, and you're going to do one single crochet. And then in the second stitch, you're going to do two single crochet. So two single crochet in the same stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. So I'll do one more with you. One single crochet in the next stitch, and then two single crochet in the second stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to your yarn marker, and then come back. Now when you reach the yarn marker, go ahead and take your crochet hook and go into that next stitch over, then yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to finish off. You're just going to yarn over and you're just going to pull enough yarn through to sew the nose onto your snout, and then go ahead and cut it. I'm not going to cut this one because I'm going to use this still, so I'm going to try to save that yarn. But this is what your nose should look like when you're done, and we're going to sew it onto the snout. Now you're just going to center your nose onto the snout, and for mine, this is the center line, and I sewed mine about the third. This is the top of the third row, and then just center it in place. And then once you have it centered, just take your tapestry needle and you're just going to sew it in place. So you just keep going in and out. And then just sew all along the edge. After you finish sewing all along the edge of the nose, you're going to take your tapestry needle and then come up through the bottom of the nose. And we're going to do the mouth. So I'm going to go down two rows. And then I'm going to go up one row and over one stitch. So up one row and over one stitch. Actually, it's two stitches. I'm going to make the smile. Go back down where you came in. And then do the same thing on the other side. Make the smile the same size. And then tie your knot on the back. Now for the puppy, we're going to start with a magic circle. Just drape the yarn across your four fingers and stabilize with your thumb. Then wrap it around your two middle fingers twice and hold it with your pinky and your thumb. And then take your crochet hook, go under those two loops around the middle fingers. You're going to bring up a loop. Then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for your slip knot. Then you're going to do six single crochet into the magic circle. So you're going to go under those two loops, bring up a loop. You have two loops on your hook. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both of those loops for a single crochet. And then you're going to do six of those. So six single crochet. You can see how I'm holding my fingers. That's three. Four. Five. And six. Then you're going to take your forefinger and your thumb, and you're going to hold it at the base of those six single crochet. You have the two loops on the other side of the magic circle. You're going to pull on one of them. If it closes, then keep on pulling on it. If not, let go and pull on the other one. So go ahead and close the magic circle loosely. You can always close it more later. Then take your loose yarn in and pull on that. Then you're going to hold your work like this, and you're going to do two single crochet into that first stitch. So you're going to go into that first stitch, and do two single crochet into the same stitch. It's one. And two. And you're going to do two single crochet into every stitch all the way around back to the beginning for a total of 12 and then come back. Now you can take and close the center of your magic circle a little more if you like. Just turn your work over and take that loose yarn in and pull on it gently or snugly until the center of the magic circle closes. Now we're going to do increase rounds. So you're going to get your yarn marker. If you don't have a yarn marker, you can just use any scraps of yarn and place it right where you left off. And then you're going to do one single crochet into the first stitch. And then in the second stitch, you're going to do two single crochet into the same stitch. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. One single crochet in the first stitch, two single crochet in the second stitch, and keep repeating that all the way around. Now we're going to do our next increase round. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. Now you're going to do one single crochet into the next two stitches. And then in the third stitch, you're going to do two single crochet in the same stitch. So one single crochet in the first two stitches, and then two single crochet in the third stitch, repeating the pattern all the way around. Now take your yarn marker and move it up for another increase round. One single crochet into the next three stitches, and then two single crochet in the fourth stitch. And repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Now this is going to be our last increase round. Go ahead and move your yarn marker up, and then you're going to do one single crochet into the next four stitches. And then in the fifth stitch, you're going to do two single crochet, and then repeat that pattern all the way around. That was our last increase round. Go ahead and move your yarn marker up. Now you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch for 10 rows. So one single crochet into every stitch for 10 rows. Now you're just going to take and put a little stuffing in the nose, the snout, and have your tapestry needle. And I moved my yarn that I left for sewing towards the bottom of the snout because I'm going to line it up with where we left off on the head. And you want to line up the bottom edge of the snout with the bottom edge of where we left off on the head. Make sure that it's straight. And then just take your tapestry needle, and then you're just going to sew along the bottom edge, just going in and out and sewing the bottom edge of the snout in place. And then you want to take and position the top part of the snout
where you
then
want it.
Then once you have the top part of the snout lined up where you want it, and then mine I have lined up starting from the center of the head. I went down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So right below the 10th row, I lined up the top part of my snout. And now I'm just going to sew across, making sure that my smile is still straight, and then just sew across the top of the snout. Then, after you have the bottom and the top sewn on, then you can start sewing the sides in place. Now for the spot, I made mine in the same black yarn that I did for the nose, but I'm going to show you how I made it with the blue yarn again. So the first thing you're going to do is a slip knot. So you just fold the yarn over on itself to form a loop, then put your crochet hook through the loop, hold it in place with your middle finger and thumb, yarn over, and bring the yarn through the loop for your slip knot. Now you're going to make a chain of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you're going to hold the last stitch with your middle finger and thumb. You're going to do one more chain. So you're going to do a chain 1. And then you're going to go into the second chain from the hook with your crochet hook, which is the stitch that you are holding. You're going to bring up a loop. You have 2 loops on the hook. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both of those loops for a single crochet. And then you're going to do a single crochet all the way back across. Your second row, just 1 single crochet into every stitch. And then after you do your single crochet in that last stitch, you're going to do a chain 1, turn your work, and here you can see at the base of that chain 1 that you did that there's a little bit of an upslope. You're not going to go into that stitch. You're going to go into the next stitch over. So now you're going to do 1 single crochet into every stitch all the way back across, and this is your third row. So then you're going to chain 1. After you're finished with the third row, you're going to turn your work, and then you're going to do 1 single crochet all the way back across for your fourth row, and then you're going to come back. So you should have just finished your fourth row. Now you're just going to turn your work, and you're going to go do a slip stitch into the next stitch over. So you're going to go into your next stitch over, and you're going to yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to do a single crochet into every stitch all the way to that last stitch, and then you're going to do a slip stitch into that last stitch. So now in this last stitch, you're going to yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. Then you're going to turn your work, and you're going to skip a stitch. So you're going to skip that next stitch and go into the next stitch and do a slip stitch. And then you're going to do a single crochet across. And then you're going to do a slip stitch into that last stitch. And then you're going to turn your work, and you're going to do a slip stitch into the next stitch, and a slip stitch into the next stitch. And then you're going to finish off. Just yarn over and pull enough yarn to sew. You cut it, and then you're going to leave enough to sew the patch or spot onto.
Now, before you sew the spot down on the dog, you're going to want to place your eyes where you think you're going to want them, and then go ahead and put your safety locks onto the back. And then once you have those, your eyes in place and the safety locks in place, then you could take your tapestry needle and you can sew the spot in place.
Now here is the boy dog's face, and you could see where I placed the eyes, and then the eyebrow, I just did a chain of 5 with the black yarn and then sewed that in place. Now I'm going to show you how I made the female puppy's eyes. So you're just going to come up with your tapestry needle and make sure you leave enough on the inside for tying a knot, and then you're just going to go up at an angle and down and then I'm just going to go over and then back down where I came out. And then across. And now I'm going to go ahead and do the eyelashes. So I'm just going to come up near the eye and then up towards the eyebrow. And then I'm going to come out the center, one row down in the center of the eye. And then across. And then I'm going to come in the center again. And then tie a knot on the inside. Now we're going to finish closing the head after we finished putting the face on. So you should have finished 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 rows. And now you're just going to move your yarn marker up, and I'm going to show you how to do the decrease rounds. So now you're going to do one single crochet into the next four stitches, and then you're going to do a decrease stitch. So I'm going to show you how you do that. You're going to do one single crochet into four stitches. And then you're going to do your decrease stitch. So you're going to go into your next stitch, bring up a loop. You have two loops on the hook. Go into the next stitch, bring up a loop. You have three loops on the hook. Yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all three for a decrease stitch. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around. So I'm going to do one more with you, one more set. Just do one single crochet into four stitches, and then you're going to do your decrease stitch, and you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker, and then come back. Once you reach the yarn marker, go ahead and move it up to the next round. And now you're going to do one single crochet into three stitches. And then you're going to do your decrease stitch. And then just repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Then move your yarn marker up, and this is our last decrease round. You're going to do one single crochet into two stitches, and then you do your decrease stitch and repeat the pattern all the way back around. So this is how your opening should be, about the size of the opening for the head. And now we're just going to do a slip stitch. So go into the next stitch over, yarn over, and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to go ahead and yarn over and finish off. And then the head is done for now. And you're going to make the body the same way that you did the head. And then come back. Now go ahead and put your pillow stuffing or whatever stuffing you're using for your stuffed animal, and then take your tapestry needle with the same colored yarn, and then you're just going to sew the head to the body. So usually I'll start in the back, and you're just going to grab a stitch in the body and then the back of the head, grab a stitch, Make sure you leave enough yarn for tying a knot. And then just come back through the head, down through the body. And this will be where you tie your knot. And then you just take your tapestry needle and you're just going to, since I came out of the body, I'm going to go back in through the body and then up through the head. And then you're just going to sew all the way around until the head is sewn on to the body. And then come back. Now when you're finished sewing the head on to the body, make sure you end up right where you left off in the beginning, so you have two yarn ends that you can take and sew, I mean not sew, but tie a knot. And then once you tie your knot, then you can take your tapestry needle, take both of your loose yarn ends, and you're going to go back in where you tied your knot, and you can come out anywhere on the body. And then you just cut your loose yarn ends. And then come back and I'll show you how to make the ears. Now to make the ears, you're going to go ahead and just fold the yarn over on itself. And then put the crochet hook through the loop and then hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and thumb. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down and go through that loop for your slip knot. And then you're going to make a chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, so here I have my chain of 10. Now you're going to hold that last stitch with your middle finger and thumb, and we're going to move up to the next row. So you're going to do a chain 1, and then you're going to work a single crochet in the second chain from the hook, which is the stitch that you're holding. So you're going to take your crochet hook and go through the second stitch from the hook. You're going to bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both loops for a single crochet. And then you're going to go do a single crochet into every stitch all the way back across. Go ahead and finish doing a single crochet into every stitch all the way back across. So I just finished the second row. Now I'm going to do a chain 1. So I'm going to yarn over, bring the yarn through the loop for a chain 1, and then you're going to turn your work and you're not going to go into the base of this first stitch where you did your chain 1. You're going to go into the next stitch over. You're going to bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet, and then you're going to do a single crochet into every stitch back across for your third row. And then I just wanted to show you, you're going to be making 4 pieces, and I chose pink for the inside color of the ear for the female dog, and for the male dog I had used my blue color, the turquoise color. So whatever colors that you want to choose, but on the outer part of the ear I did 1 black and then 1 white. Now if you use different kinds of yarn, you want to be careful with how many rows that you do. So for the black yarn, I had to do 11 rows. And for the white yarn, I had to do 10. And the pink yarn is the same type of yarn, so I did 10 rows. So since I'm working with my pink yarn, I'm going to be doing 10 rows of 1 single crochet into every stitch. So if your yarn is like the black yarn and is a little bit smaller when you do your stitches, but it ends up being the same size, then you would do however stitches you need for the middle part, how many rows. So whether it be 10 or 11, go ahead and complete how many rows that you need for your ear. And for mine, I'm going to be doing 10 rows and then come back. So I just finished my 10th row with the pink yarn. And like I said, with different yarns, it may be different lengths. So with the black yarn, I needed 11 rows. But then you do the same method as I'm doing right now. So I just finished my 10th row. Now I'm going to turn my work and I'm going to do a slip stitch into the next stitch. So take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch, yarn over, and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. Then you're going to do a single crochet all the way across until you reach the last stitch, and then you're going to do a slip stitch into that last stitch. And then you're going to turn your work, and then you're going to do a slip stitch into the next two stitches. And then you're going to do a single crochet into four stitches. And then you're going to do a slip stitch into that next stitch. Then you're going to turn your work. And you're going to do a slip stitch into the next stitch. And then a single crochet into three stitches. Then a slip stitch into the next stitch. This one's a little tough. Go ahead and get into that stitch. Do a slip stitch. Then turn your work. And then you're going to do a slip stitch into the next stitch. And then you're going to finish off. And now you just need to make two inner ear colors, and then you need your black outer ear and then your white outer ear, and then come back. Now we're going to crochet the two parts of the ear together. So I'm going to do the white side. This is the outer side of the ear and the pink side of the inner ear. I'm going to do this one first, and I'm putting the right sides showing and then putting the wrong sides together. So the right side for me is the fuzzy side, and then on the inner ear I put the fuzzy side on the outside as well. And I'm going to start, I tied a knot with my two loose yarn ends, and I'm going to take my crochet hook and just go into that first stitch on the pink as well as the first stitch on the white portion. And then I'm going to take and hook the white yarn. Make sure you leave enough loose yarn in for tying a knot. And then I'm going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the loop for a chain. And then I'm going to turn the work over and just tie a knot on the back. And now I'm going to take all of my loose yarn ends, because I'm going to bury them as I work. So I have three loose yarn ends for mine. I'm going to take my crochet hook, go into the next stitch over, making sure to grab both the pink side as well as the white side. And then I'm going to yarn over, bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. And I'm going to do a single crochet, one single crochet into every stitch across. I'm going to go behind the loose yarn ends, bring up a loop, do a single crochet. And you're going to do a single crochet into every stitch all the way around back to the beginning. Each of the corners, you can do two single crochets in each stitch around the corner. And then just one single crochet everywhere else. And then as you're moving around the curve at the bottom, you may need to do two single crochets into those stitches on the corners. And then when you come back to the beginning, come back and I'll show you how to slip stitch and finish off. Okay, so you can see how I did a border a white border all the way around. This is what it looks like on the other side. And now you're going to do a slip stitch. Go ahead and go into that next stitch over, then yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. Then you're going to yarn over to finish off, and then make sure you bring enough yarn through to sew the ear onto the dog. And now you're going to do the exact same thing, except now you have the black portion and the pink portion. So this is going to be the right side, and this is going to be the right side. I put the wrong sides together, and I'm just going to tie a knot with my loose yarn ends. And then I'm going to be using my black yarn, and I'm going to do the same thing that I did with my white yarn, crocheting around the edges, and I'm going to do the same thing with the black yarn for this ear. Now you're just going to line up your ears where you want them, and I've already lined up the black one and sewed it in place. Now I have the white ear where I would like to have the white ear. So then I just take my tapestry needle, and then I just go into the ear and the body, and then come up just like this with the tapestry needle. And then you're just going to sew the ear in place. And then I'm going to sew back across to the back of the ear. And then once I reach the back of the ear, I'm going to go down into the head and then back up. Then I'm going to tie a knot. Just going to go through twice, make sure it's nice and secure. And then once I have the knot tied, then you're going to go straight down where you tied the knot, and you can come out anywhere on the head. And then just cut your loose yarn end. And then I have the ears sewn on. And I put the white ear, the top part is about to the top of the eye, and about couple stitches over, and about a stitch over from the eyebrow, and also level with the eye. And those are my two ears. Now for the feet, we're going to make them all the same way. And we're going to start with a magic circle. So you just drape the yarn across your four fingers and use your thumb to stabilize. And then wrap it around your two middle fingers twice and hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. And then you're going to bring up a loop. Then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. And now you're going to do six single crochet into the magic circle, just like we did before. And then we're going to grab the base of those six single crochet and then close the magic circle. And then we're going to do two single crochet into every stitch around for a total of 12. So when you finish two stitches in every stitch around for a total of 12, come back and I'll show you what to do next. Now we're going to do our increase round. So you're going to need your yarn marker. Go ahead and place your yarn marker right where you left off, and you're going to do one single crochet into the next stitch, and then two single crochet into the second stitch. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around, back to the yarn marker, and then come back. I've reached the yarn marker. Now go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And we're going to do the last increase round. You're going to do one single crochet in the next two stitches, and then two single crochet into the third stitch. And repeat that pattern all the way around to the yarn marker. Go ahead and move your yarn marker up. And now you're just going to do one round of one single crochet into every stitch. So go ahead and do one single crochet all the way around. Now we're going to be working in the back loops only. So I just want to show you this stitch. Here is the stitch, and we're going to go right down the center of the stitch, and we're going to grab the back loop only. So here you have the back loop, and then here you have the front loop. So with our crochet hook, we're going to go right down the center, and we're going to grab that back loop only. So now take your yarn marker and move it up. And you're going to take your crochet hook, and you're going to go right down the center of the next stitch. And you're going to grab that back loop only. You're going to bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet. And you're going to do a single crochet into the next 14 back loops, and then come back. So I just did a single crochet into the back loop of 14 stitches. Now you're going to go into the next loop, but you're going to go under both loops. Bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet. So now you're just going to do a single crochet all the way back to the yarn marker and then come back. Move the yarn marker up, and now you're going to do a round of one single crochet into every stitch. So go ahead and do one round of one single crochet into every stitch, and then come back. Your work should be looking like this, and I'm going to use this. The side that your loose yarn end is hanging out is my right side, because it has the fuzzier side. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up, and now we're going to do decrease stitches. We're going to do 7 decrease stitches, and I'm going to show you the first couple. So you just go into the next stitch. You bring up a loop, go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, three loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through those three loops for a decrease stitch. So that was one decrease stitch. I'm going to do one more with you, but you're going to finish doing 7. So that's 2. Go ahead and finish doing 7 decrease stitches and then come back. You can see how those 7 decrease stitches formed a little pooch there for the paw. Now you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch back to the yarn marker. So one single crochet all the way back, and then I'm going to go ahead and take that yarn marker and move it up. Now you're going to go ahead and do 7 rows of one single crochet into every stitch. So go ahead and do one single crochet into every stitch for 7 rounds and then come back. So now you should have finished 7 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then go ahead and stuff your paw or your foot. And then come back. Now, we're going to go ahead and close the foot. So we're just going to do decrease stitches around until the foot is closed. And then I'll show you how to slip stitch it. Once we've finished doing decreases down to where we can't do decreases anymore, I'll show you how we can slip stitch the foot closed. So you just keep doing decrease stitches around, and I'll do a slow one here. Go into the next stitch, pull up a loop, Go into the next stitch, pull up a loop, three loops on the hook, yarn over and go through all three for a decrease. And you're just going to keep doing decreases all the way around. You can see how the foot is closing. I'm going to do a couple more, and then I'll show you how to do the slip stitch. We're almost closed. Now you can take and skip a stitch, work into the next stitch, go into that stitch, yarn over, and pull the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. You can go right across, yarn over, and pull through both loops for a slip stitch. Now we can finish off, yarn over, and then pull just enough yarn to bury into the work. So now you can bury your loose yarn ends. So you just take your tapestry needle and put the loose yarn in onto the end of your tapestry needle. Then you're going to take your tapestry needle and just go into the foot, and you can come out anywhere. And then just cut that loose yarn end. So go ahead and bury all of your loose yarn ends, and then you need to make four of these and then come back. Okay, so now you should have four feet made all the same way. Go ahead and grab two of them, and we're going to put the arms on first. So you're going to make sure that your paws are facing up, and then place them along the side of the dog and line them up the way you want. Make sure that when you line them up, that when you put the paws up, you're happy with the distance. And then once you have them lined up, come back and I'll show you how to sew them on. Once you have them lined up, just grab your tapestry needle with your yarn, and you're going to go pinch together the arms. This is how I have mine. You see how I have them pinched closely with the body. And then I'm going to take my tapestry needle, and I'm going to go in about four rows down. And I'm going to go through the body and out the other side at about the same distance. Make sure that you leave enough yarn on the other side for sewing and tying your knot. And then just go about a stitch over, and then you're going to come back out on the other side. And you want to come out about a stitch over from where you went in. And then just make sure that it went down snugly, and then just let it open up so the body opens up. And then you're going to take and tie a knot on the side. And then you can just make sure that you like the way the paws look. And then if you're happy with how it looks, you're going to go and do the same thing one more time. And then once you've gone through twice and your arms are sewn on, then you can take your tapestry needle and you're going to go back in through the knot and out anywhere on the paw. And then just cut your loose yarn end. Go ahead and bury your other loose yarn end the same way. And then you're going to come back and do the feet the same way. Now I've lined up my feet, and I'm about a row beneath my arms on both sides. And I'm going to go through. This time I'm going about a couple rows, three rows down. I'm going to go through the body and out the other side. Again, I'm leaving plenty of yarn. I'm going to stitch over and then come out on the other side. that a stitch over. Make sure that your yarn lays flat. And then you can open up the belly and then just tie your knot. And then after you tie your knot, you're going to do this one more time. Go back through with your tapestry needle one more time. So you just grip it. And then take your tapestry needle and then go back in for a second just to make sure it's nice and sturdy. And then tie your knot and bury your loose yarn ends and then come back. Now to make the tail, you're just going to grab the white yarn, drape it across your four middle fingers. We're going to do a magic circle and stabilize with your thumb and then wrap it around your two middle fingers twice and hold it with your pinky and your thumb. And then just take your crochet hook, bring up a loop, yarn over, turn the hook upside down and go through that loop for a slip knot. And then you're going to do six single crochet into the magic circle. And then you're going to hold the base of the six single crochet just like we did before. And then we're going to close the magic circle. And then you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch around. So go ahead and do one single crochet into every stitch around until you have the size of the tail that you want. So one single crochet into every stitch around until you've completed the size of tail.
Okay, so I did six rows of single crochet for my tail.
And so now when you're done, you just go into the next stitch over and then you yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch and then just yarn over and bring the yarn through the loop to finish off and make sure you bring enough yarn through to sew the tail onto the dog. And then before you sew the tail on, this is the right side for me and I have my loose yarn end that's still out. So I'm going to go ahead and take my tapestry needle and I'm just going to take that loose yarn in. I'm going to go right back through the center of the tail and just bring that yarn through and then I'm going to go ahead and cut that loose yarn end. And now my tail is done. So I'm going to take the tapestry needle onto the long end that I left for sewing. And then you're just going to take the dog and you're going to position the tail where you want it. And then once you have the tail in position where you want it, you're going to go into the body with the tapestry needle. And then you're just going to come up through the tail. And then you're just going to sew the tail to the body. Now, if you like the painted fingernails, I'm going to show you how to do that. So you're going to take the paw, whatever paw that you're going to be working with, and you're going to start on the outer aspect of the paw first. So you're just going to go in and then up, two rows up. Make sure you leave a long enough end for tying a knot. And then you're going to go back in where you came out. And you're going to go over, you're going to skip one, two, three stitches. So you can see how I went back in where I started and then out three stitches over and two stitches up. And then I'm going to go straight down two rows and then over. So skipped 1, 2, 3 stitches. And then just go straight down and then back across where you started. And you can see how it makes the painted toenails. And then you just tie a knot. Then you take your tapestry needle, take your loose yarn ends, and you're going to go right where you did the knot, go into the out back of the foot, and then just cut your loose yarn in. So go ahead and bury your other loose yarn in, and then come back. Now with the spots, I'm going to show you how to make them with the black yarn, because I showed you how to do magic circle and some stitches, so even though it's difficult to see with the black yarn, you should be able to still follow. Go ahead and drape the yarn across your 4 fingers and use your thumb to stabilize, and then wrap it around your 2 middle fingers twice and hold it with your pinky and your thumb. And this is where you get to have fun with your spots, and there's no right way or wrong way to do it. You can do it any way that you like, but to start with, you just put your crochet hook under the 2 loops and bring up a loop, and then we're going to do our slip knot. So you yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for your slip knot. And now you can do any stitches that you want into the magic circle. So you can do a single crochet, or you can do a half double crochet, yarn over, go into the magic circle, bring up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, and then go through all 3 for a half double crochet. You can do a double crochet, yarn over, go into the magic circle, bring up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and go through 2, yarn over and go through 2, and then you can do another half double crochet. And you can do more than 1 half double crochet. I'm going to do a total of 4. And then I'm going to do 2 single crochets. And then once you're done making whatever stitches that you want into the magic circle, take your forefinger and thumb. And then you'll have the 2 loops on the opposite side of the circle, just like we did before. We're going to close it. And then you're going to take and do a slip stitch into that first stitch that you made. So you just go into that first stitch. And then you yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to finish off. Just yarn over and bring enough yarn through to sew the spot onto the dog. So you can go ahead and close your magic circle and just turn it over and pull on that loose yarn in. And then you have a shaped spot. So I'm going to do a few more with you. So this is one that I like to do also. So I did my slip knot, and now I'm going to do 2 single crochet. Now I'm going to do 2 half double crochet. Now I'm going to do 2 double crochet. Then 2 half double crochet. And then 2 single crochet. Two half double crochet. Two double crochet. And what's nice about the magic circle is you can scoot your work over if you need to also. And then I'm going to do 2 half double crochet. And then I'm going to go ahead and close my magic circle. And then I'm just going to do a slip stitch. And then finish off. And then I'm going to go ahead and close my magic circle. And it makes a little bit of a heart-shaped spot. And then you have another spot. So then I'm going to just do one more spot with you. And this one's an easy one. And you can do whatever stitches you want in your spot. So like I said, there's no right way or wrong way. It's just fun. So now I'm going to start with a half double crochet. So I'm going to do a single crochet and then a chain one. So it's actually like a chain two, which is equivalent to a half double crochet. I'm going to yarn over, go into the magic circle, bring up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and go through all 3 for a half double crochet. And I'm going to do 6 half double crochet. And just for fun, I'm going to throw in a double crochet, another half double crochet, and then a single crochet. Then I'm going to close it. So you can do whatever you want. Go ahead and make as many spots as you want. Go ahead and do a slip stitch into that first stitch. And then finish off. So go ahead and make all the spots that you want to put on your dog, and then I'm going to show you how to sew the spots on the dog. So once you make all of your spots, you're going to sew them onto your dog, and I'm just going to take my tapestry needle and put it on one of the loose yarn ends, and then you're going to take, place the dot spot where you want it, and then go into the body and grab a stitch with your tapestry needle, and then come up through the spot, and then I just leave one of the loose yarn ends hanging while I take the other one to sew. And then I just go down into the body and then up and just sew the spot to the body, just going in and out, sewing the spot to the body. And then when you're done, come up near your other loose yarn end. I'm just going to sew a few more, sew down the spot a little bit better. And then once I have the spot sewn on the way I like it, I'm just going to go in and out near where my other loose yarn end is. And then once I do that, I can tie a knot. And then you just bury your loose yarn ends. And how I do that is I just take the tapestry needle. I go in right where I tied the knot and then come out anywhere on the back or on the body and then just cut your loose yarn in. So go ahead, bury all of your loose yarn ends and sew on all your spots and then come back. Now I just want to show a close-up of the dogs. So here's one of the puppies. And I'm naming this one Spot. And here's the back. And what's nice about Spot is the paws move up and down. And so do the legs. And then you can take the hat off. And this is what Spot looks like without his hat. And here's a close-up of the female puppy. And here you can see the hat. And from behind. And she also moves her paws and her feet. And then here is the big female dog. And you can see how pretty her eyes are. And her hat. And this is what she looks like from behind. And I made her design a little bit different, so she doesn't, her legs don't move. She just sits up straight. And that's the same way that I made. And his name is Sparkles. He's got his little fireman hat. So he's the same way. He just sits also. Just turn him around. And then those are the dogs.